Having blown theatrical minds in limited cinemas across the globe, there's no doubt that Annette is the strangest musical since Sweeney Todd. With its Amazon Prime launch set for August 20th, you might be asking whether it's worth the watch. Join us as we take a look into what makes this film so highly anticipated. Number one, it's the first true Sparks Brothers musical. First of all, the anticipation following this film around like the tail of a donkey has a lot to do with the musical geniuses behind the soundtrack of the performance. We're talking about the Sparks Brothers, which is the name given to the eccentric pop duo consisting of brothers Russell and Ron Mayall. For those of you who haven't heard about this group, go ahead and watch this year's documentary of the same name made by Portugal filmmaker Edgar Wright. It's in this film that he explores the many times that the Sparks Brothers attempted to create their own musical for the silver screen. Their very first opportunity came at the hands of actor and director Jacques Tati, who in the late 1970s wanted to bring them on for a French musical similar in nature to Les Misérables. But unfortunately for them, Tati passed away before the project was even able to enter the production phase. The brothers were then approached by Tim Burton with another peculiar idea, which had at its basis the adaptation of the popular manga Kai, the Missing Girl. But as incredible as the idea seemed to them, the studio heading the project believed it to be too much of a risk considering the budget that would be required to make it work. Now, almost 50 years after the brothers were supposed to make their first transition to the silver screen, we have Annette, which has been described as none other than a demented rock opera that blurs the lines between reality and fiction. Serving alongside the Sparks Brothers is Léos Carax, the world-renowned French director who has promised to bring the conceptualizations of the brothers to the screen precisely how the duo envisioned them. With a director's guidance, of course. Annette is a project that has been a long time coming. Although it will most certainly not win everyone over, those with a taste for the weird and wonderful will most certainly find a home in the arms of the film. Think of a mesh between A Star is Born and Corpse Bride, and you'll find Annette somewhere in the middle. Not exactly a shoe-in for any Oscars, but most certainly a worthy watch considering the journey that the Sparks Brothers have been on in the past few decades. Number two, the plot is both ridiculous and heavy. Fans of Adam Driver will also love the fact that he plays a provocative stand-up comedian by the name of Henry McHenry in the film, who is also nicknamed the Ape of God. While his acts are absolutely plastered with the ramblings of a self-loathing psychopath who enjoys musical interventions, he plays the role like an absolute professional, believing that he has actually gone off the rails for real this time. But he isn't alone in the world. He also has a wife by the name of Anne, who is being portrayed by the charismatic Marion Cotillard. As a professional opera singer, she yearns to have the audience know her in the same way as her husband's audience knows him. But since her characters pass away after each and every performance, this simply cannot be the case. But the duo seem to work together, with their highly publicized and watched relationship finally resulting in the birth of a little girl who shares the name of the film. The birth of Annette is, however, just the beginning. After a number of women come forward documenting the abuse that McHenry inflicted upon them in the past, his career starts heading in a downward trajectory. But that's when he finds solace in Annette, who as a baby has one of the most angelic voices he has ever set his ears to. It doesn't take long for Simon Helberg of the Big Bang Theory fame to make Annette one of the greatest pop stars of her time, which is crazy considering just how young she actually is. It's here that things may get a bit too strange for the usual lovers of musical theater, as the singing baby Annette is portrayed by a life-sized puppet. Good thing too, as a CGI singing baby sounds like absolute nightmare fuel. Point is, the film is supposed to be ridiculous, but deals with some of the most harrowing topics and experiences that call for discussion in today's day and age. Without giving too much away, your laughter will turn to heartbreak, and in no time at all, you'll find yourself lost in the strangeness that is Annette. But as we mentioned earlier, this won't be everyone's cup of tea. Number three, Annette is Carax's most accessible film. French film students will tell you that Léos Carax is one of the greatest directors of our time, but his other credited titles have been largely unnoticed by the public due to their highly artistic appeal. Not everyone who appreciates film will like the ongoing plot of Pola X or King Lear after all. So, if you had heard his name but haven't been able to find the titles that have made him popular, Annette is most certainly the film for you. It's considered to be his first directed feature in almost a decade, and just so happens to be one of his only works that English speakers won't have to watch using subtitles. But unlike his other films, Annette has been compared to the likes of Beauty and the Beast, Pinocchio, and A Star is Born, making it one of his most accessible titles in recent history. While you may not have access to this title at your nearest cinema due to the effects of the global health situation, it will be coming to Amazon Prime in just under 2 weeks' time. With the skill that Carax uses to paint the story in the way that it needs to be told, you really owe it to yourself to watch at least one of his feature films, all of which appear to have a strangeness in common. What better way to do this than by enjoying the incredible performance of Adam Driver, Marion Cotillard, and a creepy little puppet? Simply put, you couldn't ask for a better combination. Number 4, it's a musical that crosses the line. One of the many problems regular viewers have with musicals is that they often take the audience outside of an experience in order to replace dialogue with song. This isn't always the case, of course. We have to make reference to Les Misérables, which really leaned into the incorporation of the music into each and every scene. But even when dealing with a masterpiece like Les Misérables, there are some lines that musicals never seem to cross. Why, for example, does a character that sees the world in song never break out into a musical solo when alone on the toilet, or when filled with an overabundance of emotion whilst having sexual intercourse with his or her partner? It's not exactly a question that is often asked, but it's most certainly one that the Sparks Brothers and Leos Carax attempted to address in this strange parody turned incredible film. This is why viewers of Annette will witness musical numbers coming out of nowhere in scenes that no other musical has ever tried to make work. Graphic sex set to music that the intertwined cast members are actually singing, definitely a niche market, but one that we didn't necessarily know we wanted to be a part of. The best thing about these scenes is that there is a certain amount of realism about them. Regardless of how ridiculous they may seem at first, this is mostly due to the fact that Carax deviated from the process followed by classic musicals. For those of you who don't know, the usual scenario cast members are faced with is the actual acting of the scene, with the singing track having been recorded beforehand and played over the scene to make things easier. But Carax had other things in mind, asking the cast members of Annette to both act and sing live while attending to the complicated tasks at hand. In other words, you shouldn't be expecting the music to be 100% perfect. This makes sense considering the positions that you'll find the cast in while singing. It's pretty difficult to sing on point when performing the backstroke after all, or pretending to have sex with your fellow cast member. None of the actors on set are formally trained singers, which makes their brilliant performance more enjoyable than others that appear to be more put on in nature. Number 5, the original music of the film is catchier than a Disney original. Last but not least, Annette is surprising in that it provides the audience with more musical talent than anyone ever thought could come out of this cast. This is another prime example of the professionalism and talent that is brought to the fore by the writing of the Sparks Brothers. While watching the heaviest of scenes, you'll find yourself humming along to the strangest songs, leading you to ask yourself, why on earth are you enjoying the subject matter so much? In fact, with around 40 songs to choose from throughout the runtime of the film, there's no doubt that you'll find at least one that you'll want to add to your Spotify playlist. If you're a lover of music, but find most musicals to be boring, there's no doubt that Annette is the feature film for you. We wholeheartedly agree that it's a film that just has to be watched. What do you think about Annette? Be sure to let us know in the comment section down below.